History of everything, the universe. 13.8 billion years ago, our universe was compressed into an unimaginably small volume of space, and it began as an infinitely hot, dense fireball. Space and time was warped and turbulent with a foamy character. Within this space-time foam, a quantum fluctuation gave rise to our universe, which burst into existence, and there was a sudden and rapid stretching of space everywhere. The fundamental forces emerged, and the first atoms, the building blocks of everything we see around us today, were created. The universe was filled with a gaseous fog, and over time, gas clouds were pulled together by gravity to become more and more dense until nuclear fusion took place and the first stars were born. Stars act as furnaces, forging heavier elements from the lighter elements they are made of. First-generation stars only lived for a few million years, and once they burned through their fuel, they died in a supernova, spewing out an enriched cloud of elements. Then a process of stellar recycling occurred. Gravitational attraction pulled the debris of the previous generation of stars together until a new star was created, which then went on to create heavier and heavier elements. In this way, every subsequent generation of stars created a richer composition of heavier elements than the previous generation. We are often said to be made of star stuff, and it is because the elements that make up everything in the universe, including us, have been forged within the guts of these stars. Gravitational attraction created not only stars, but also the other structures we see in the night sky. Galaxies, groups of galaxies, clusters of galaxies, and superclusters of galaxies. Our Sun is a thousandth generation star, and matter coalesced around it to form the planets, asteroids, and comets of our solar system. Earth. 4.5 billion years ago, our planet Earth emerged as a third planet from the Sun. The planet was covered by molten rock, and volcanic activity released trapped gas, which created the primordial atmosphere. Over time, as the Earth cooled, lighter material rose to the surface and solidified to form the Earth's outer crust. Heavier materials sank towards the center to create an iron-nickel core. Our planet's rotation and molten iron-nickel core gave rise to a magnetic field, which protects the Earth from solar and cosmic particle radiation. This magnetic field also prevents the erosion of our atmosphere by solar wind. The magnetic field is what causes compass needles to point to the North Pole, regardless of where you are. But every few hundred thousand years, a magnetic reversal takes place, and after the next switch is completed, compass needles will point to the South Pole instead. A small planet about the size of Mars collided with the early Earth, and the debris from this impact collected in an orbit around Earth to form the Moon. This collision left the world tilted on its axis, which causes our yearly cycle of seasons. The gravitational pull between the Moon and Earth stabilized our planet, preventing it from wobbling and being subject to wild climate swings. Before the formation of our Moon, our early Earth spun so rapidly on its axis that one day lasted only 6 hours. Over time, the gravity of the Moon slowed down the Earth's rotation so that one rotation now completes in approximately 24 hours, which has resulted in our 24-hour day. As the Earth cooled, water vapor in the atmosphere was able to condense and pour down over millions of years to form the oceans of our planet. Earth is the only planet in our solar system that has a large amount of liquid water. If we were any closer to the Sun, the planet would not be able to cool down enough to have liquid water on its surface, and if we were any further away, the water would be frozen in ice. The prevailing theory of how Earth got its water is that it came from the dust, gas, and ice that formed the planet, as well as visiting comets and asteroids which were covered in sheets of ice. About 70% of our planet Earth is covered in water. Life. 3.8 billion years ago, in Earth's water, inanimate chemistry came together to give rise to biology, and life appeared on planet Earth. Some 2.8 billion years ago, underwater bacteria figured out how to use sunlight and carbon dioxide to release energy. This process is called photosynthesis, and it releases oxygen as a waste byproduct. At first, the oxygen rusted the iron in the ocean, and then, in what is known as the Great Oxidation Event, the oxygen escaped out of the oceans to build up in the atmosphere. Some bacteria learned how to use this oxygen, and life became more complex. the earliest plants and animals evolved. 541 million years ago, the Cambrian explosion saw a great diversification of animal life. When living things reproduce, they create offspring that inherit a mix of their parents' traits, as well as developing traits of their own. Small changes can add up over multiple generations to create dramatic changes, and organisms evolve into different species. It is thought that all life today evolved from a universal common ancestor. Oxygen atoms and molecules in the atmosphere combined to form the ozone layer, which shields the Earth from biologically lethal UV radiation from the sun. This allowed the first plants and animals to move from the ocean to the land. Our amphibian ancestors were tied to the water, as they had to return to the oceans, seas, lakes, and rivers to give birth to their young. But with the evolution of the egg, where water is contained within a case, they were able to give birth on land, thus being able to make the move to land permanent. About 300 million years ago, the Earth had one massive supercontinent called Pangea. Plate tectonics explains how giant areas of the Earth's crust, called plates, move around the surface of the Earth. These movements cause supercontinents to form and break up every 300 to 400 million years. About 240 million years ago, the first dinosaurs evolved. These dinosaurs ruled the Earth until a mass extinction event occurred approximately 66 million years ago. Nearly 75% of all living species were eliminated owing to a combination of factors, including an asteroid impact, choking chemicals from erupting volcanoes, and climate change. Mass extinctions are not unusual in Earth's history. We know of four other instances of mass extinction before the one that wiped out the dinosaurs. The death of the dinosaurs allowed mammals to flourish. These mammals would eventually evolve into many species, including humans. Humans. Primates arose from small terrestrial mammals, and these primates were adapted to living in trees. They had large brains, forward-facing eyes that allowed accurate depth perception, and dexterous hands. Some 5 to 7 million years ago, grasslands appeared all over the world, invading woodland habitats, which forced some of our ape ancestors in Africa from the trees onto the land. These ape ancestors learned how to walk on 2 feet in order to be able to stand upright and spot danger from far away. This allowed them to free up their hands for other tasks. Roughly 2.6 million years ago, the first humans emerged and learned how to use modified stones as tools, thus ushering in the Stone Age. The Stone Age is the first period in the three-age system used to divide the timeline of human pre-literary history. The Stone Age is followed by the Bronze Age, which is followed by the Iron Age. The Bronze Age and Iron Age will be discussed later in this video. 2 million years ago, several different species of humans roamed the landscape. Some 1 million to 400,000 years ago, humans learned how to create and manipulate fire. This gave the species the ability to cook food and release more energy from it, which helped to support the development of even larger brains. 300,000 years ago, humans lived in small hunter-gatherer groups. These early humans had developed both culture and early language. 200,000 years ago, anatomically modern humans emerged. Around 70,000 years ago, behaviorally modern humans emerged. Human evolution had developed brains capable of abstract and symbolic thinking. 60,000 years ago, modern humans left Africa and spread across the globe. The Earth's climate alternates between ice ages and greenhouse periods. Within ice ages, there are periods of colder climate known as glacial periods and warmer ones known as interglacial periods. We are currently in an interglacial period. 20,000 years ago, when the planet was going through a glacial period and sea levels had plummeted, the Bering Land Bridge connecting Siberia and North America emerged, allowing humans to make their way to the Americas. When temperatures climbed, the land bridge disappeared and the two halves of the world were cut off from each other. Over time, for reasons unknown, the other species of humans died out and only modern humans were left. Approximately 12,000 years ago marked another turning point in the history of man. Humans discovered farming, which allowed them to transition from the hunter-gatherer lifestyle to one of agriculture and settlement. Shortly thereafter, the first villages and towns appeared. Civilizations. The earliest civilizations emerged on the banks of river valleys as humans needed to be near reliable sources of water for drinking and growing food crops. The earliest civilizations include the Sumerians in Mesopotamia, modern-day Iraq, the ancient Egyptians, the Indus Valley Civilization in modern-day Pakistan and northern India, the ancient Chinese, and the Norte Chico Civilization in modern-day Peru. Early societies developed governments, economies, social hierarchies, distinct cultures, and religions. The wheel, the plow, and the sail were all invented, facilitating agriculture and trade. Writing also developed independently and at different times in several different areas of the world. The Bronze Age began when metalworking advanced to a point where bronze was created using copper and tin, and it also marked the beginning of early urban civilizations. Horses originated in the Americas and crossed over to Eurasia via the Bering Land Bridge. Horse-based cavalries and chariots meant that well-organized armies emerged, allowing for the first empires to be established, such as the Akkadian Empire in Mesopotamia. In Crete, the rise of the Minoans marked the first advanced civilization in Europe. In Africa, the kingdom of Kush established itself as a regional power. The kingdom was both a trading partner and a military rival of Egypt. In China, the first of the ancient dynasties emerged, the Xia dynasty, which was followed by the Shang dynasty. In North America, the poverty point culture, noted for its mound building tradition, developed. In Mesoamerica, the first major civilization to emerge were the Olmecs, famous for creating colossal stone head sculptures. In Anatolia, the Hittite Empire emerged. A volcanic eruption spelled the end of the Minoans, who were replaced by the Mycenaeans. In India, the Vedic culture evolved and the foundations of Hinduism were laid and a hierarchy of social classes was established. Around 1200 BCE, knowledge of iron metalworking spread, marking the end of the Bronze Age and the beginning of the Iron Age. The Phoenicians were a people that originated from the Levant region of the Eastern Mediterranean. Known for being expert seafarers and intrepid explorers, their lasting legacy was the Phoenician alphabet, which is the basis for several writing systems that are used in the world today. The ancient city of Carthage began as a Phoenician settlement in what is now Tunisia, and it grew into a sprawling seafaring empire. In the 5th and 6th century, a set of transformative philosophical and religious ideas were developed, notably Chinese Confucianism, Indian Buddhism, Jewish monotheism, and Greek philosophy. In and around 550 BCE, the Achaemenid Empire, also known as the First Persian Empire, emerged. The years between 336 BCE to 323 BCE saw the reign of Alexander the Great, the king of the ancient Greek kingdom of Macedonia. He created one of the largest empires of the ancient world, which stretched from Greece to northwestern India. His conquest meant a diffusion of ancient Greek culture and influence throughout the region. From 322 BCE, most of South Asia was united to the Maurya Empire by Chandragupta Maurya, and the region went on to flourish under the Indian Emperor Ashoka the Great. In China, the first imperial dynasty was founded, the Qin Dynasty, which lasted only 15 years and was followed by the Han Empire. Around 4 BCE, Jesus was born, a Jewish preacher who would go on to become the central figure in Christianity. In Europe, around 27 BCE, the Roman Empire was founded. The relative peace of empires allowed international trade routes to be established, most notably the massive trade routes in the Mediterranean, the maritime trade web in the Indian Ocean, and the Silk Road. These trade routes were a means of cultural interaction and learning between the different civilizations. Han China and the Roman Empire lay at the opposite ends of the Silk Road and were comparable in power and influence, both developing many innovations such as paper and blast furnaces in China and improved road engineering in the Roman Empire. In Africa, from about 100 CE, the Empire of Aksum flourished as a major trading empire, dominating its neighbors and controlling business in the Red Sea. A century or so later, camels were introduced to the Sahara, which opened up the trans-Saharan trade route. This would allow the Ghana Empire to rise and grow rich from trading salt and gold. After Han China fell into civil war, the Three Kingdoms' tripartite division was established, with three rival states battling for control of China. In 224 CE, the last of the great Persian empires, the Sasanian Empire, emerged. It would be a leading world power for a period of more than 400 years before being displaced by Islamic caliphates. Around the same time, on the other side of the world, Mayan culture reached its zenith, developing astronomy, calendar and writing systems, and building ceremonial temples and structures. In 312 CE, the Roman Emperor Constantine converted to Christianity, which would help elevate the religion from a small sect into one of the world's great religions. In 324 CE, he also established the city of Constantinople, formerly Byzantium and now modern-day Istanbul, as the second capital of the Roman Empire. At its height, the Gupta Empire ruled much of the Indian subcontinent and all of northern India. In southern India, three prominent Dravidian kingdoms emerged. This period oversaw ancient India's golden age, where advances were made in several fields, including science, technology, and mathematics. In 395 CE, the Roman Empire was permanently divided between West and East. The Huns were a nomadic tribe that moved into the regions around the Western Roman Empire, which in turn caused Germanic tribes to move into Western Roman territory. The resulting conflicts led to the fall of the western half of the Roman Empire. The Eastern Roman Empire would come to be known as the Byzantine Empire, the Middle Ages. Over time, smaller kingdoms were established across Europe, and Christianity became the main religion. Around 570 CE, Muhammad was born. He was a merchant who went on to become the founder of Islam, successfully bringing together warring tribes across the Middle East and giving them a common purpose under the new religion. At a similar time, after a chaotic period in Chinese history, the Sui dynasty successfully reunified the whole of China and laid the foundations for a Chinese golden age under the Tang dynasty, when gunpowder was invented by Chinese alchemists. The Shia-Sunni split in Islam occurred after 632 CE as a result of disagreement over who would succeed Muhammad following his death. 661 CE saw the rise of the Umayyad Caliphate, the second of the four major caliphates established after the death of Muhammad. The Umayyads continued the Muslim Arab conquest begun by Muhammad. These conquests saw a century of rapid expansion of territory and the spread of the Islamic religion and culture. This was followed by the Islamic Golden Age, which saw the world benefit from Muslim medical discoveries, their preservation of Greek, Persian, and Roman texts, and their adoption of innovations from across the world. 1054 CE saw the break of communion between the Catholic Church and the Eastern Orthodox Church. The separation was a culmination of many religious and political differences which had developed between Western and Eastern Christianity. Throughout the 11th century, Turks from Central Asia settled in Anatolia, modern-day Turkey. From 1095 CE to 1291 CE, a series of religious wars known as the Crusades were fought between Christians and Muslims as the former battled to take back control of holy sites considered sacred by both groups. This considerably weakened the Byzantine Empire. The Mongol Empire grew under the leadership of Genghis Khan, who united several nomadic tribes in Northeast Asia. The Mongols then swept through much of Eurasia and established the largest contiguous land empire in history. In West Africa, the Mali Empire emerged, and the wealth of its rulers, in particular Mansa Musa, put it on the map. Mansa Musa was the richest person to have ever lived. On his Islamic pilgrimage to Mecca, he passed through Egypt and gave out so much gold that it took years for the Egyptian economy to recover. From 1299 CE, the Ottoman Turks established the Ottoman Empire. After 1354 CE, the Ottomans crossed into Europe, and after they conquered the Balkans, the Ottoman Beylik became a transcontinental empire. From 1300 CE, the Aztecs, a Mesoamerican culture, flourished in what is now central Mexico. Between 1346 CE to 1353 CE, the world was visited by one of the deadliest pandemics in human history, the Black Death. The disease resulted in a massive loss of life, killing up to an estimated 75 to 200 million people globally. 30 to 60% of the entire population of Europe was wiped out, and population growth did not resume until a full century later. In 1368 CE, after about a century of Mongol Yuan dynasty rule, the ethnic Han Chinese reasserted control with the founding of the Ming dynasty. From the 14th century to the 17th century, the European Renaissance took place. It was a movement that emphasized the value and agency of human beings, individually and collectively. The Renaissance preferred logic and evidence over acceptance of dogma or superstition. Around 1438 CE, the Inca Empire was flourishing in Western South America. In 1440 CE, Gutenberg's printing press was invented, which meant that learning was no longer limited to a select few, as a mass distribution of written material was made possible. In 1453 CE, the Byzantine Empire finally fell when the Ottoman Turks captured Constantinople. The 15th century marked the beginning of the Age of Discovery, when Christopher Columbus discovered the Americas and thus the two hemispheres of the world were once again connected. During this period in history, European kingdoms embarked on civilizing missions to the New World, which would destroy the native people's existing way of life. Back in Europe, a religious struggle questioning the absolute authority and practices of the Roman Catholic Church resulted in the Reformation, where Protestants broke off from the Catholic Church. From the 16th century onward, several European powers set up colonies in Africa, Asia, the Americas, and Oceania. This caused changes in culture, language, society, and economics. It also caused the death of millions of native people as European nations brutalized the indigenous populations. As European empires required labor to exploit the resources of the New World, they established the transatlantic slave trade, where enslaved African people were transported by slave traders mainly to the Americas. Slavery had existed before, but not on the same industrial scale. Between 1526 CE to 1857 CE, the classic period of the Mughal Empire saw the region enjoy economic progress as well as religious harmony. Between 1543 CE to 1687 CE, a series of events marked the emergence of modern science, including the publication of Nicolaus Copernicus's book On the Revolutions of the Heavenly Spheres and Isaac Newton's Mathematical Principles of Natural Philosophy. In 1547 CE, Ivan the Terrible was crowned the first Tsar of Russia, and by annexing the Turkic Khanates in the east, he transformed Russia into a regional power. Modern times. Around the 17th century, Mughal India became the world's largest economic power, accounting for 24.4% of world GDP. The Qing dynasty, which was to be the last Chinese imperial dynasty, was established in 1636 CE. The Qing dynasty would fight with Western powers in the Opium Wars because Western traders would sell the highly addictive drug to the Chinese population. The West was easily able to defeat the Qing dynasty with their modern warfare technology, and upon victory, they forced the Qing government to not only grant favorable tariffs and trade conditions, but also to hand over territory. In 1912 CE, the Qing dynasty was replaced by the Republic of China. Between 1757 CE to 1858 CE, the British East India Company took over large parts of India as the Mughal Empire declined. Later, the British Crown assumed direct control of the Indian subcontinent in the form of the new British Raj. 1775 CE saw the American Revolution as the 13 British colonies revolted against British rule. The colonies declared independence in 1776 CE, which began the formation of the United States of America. The Industrial Revolution occurred from 1760 CE to about 1840 CE, and this was a major turning point in human history as machines replaced man's muscle power. Steam engines, the locomotive, telegraphic communications, the first electric generator, and the factory system were all invented and introduced during this period. The French Revolution occurred between 1789 CE to 1799 CE. It was triggered as a result of much misery and hunger among the common people of France as the French treasury was drained, partly due to the monarchy helping to bankroll the American Revolution against their British rivals. The ideals of the French Revolution would go on to inspire several other revolutionary uprisings across the globe. This would result in the creation of a number of independent countries in Latin America. From 1861 CE to 1865 CE, the American Civil War took place. The conflict was the result of a long-standing disagreement over the institution of slavery. A collection of southern states attempted to break away from the Union, and when the Union won, slavery was made illegal, delivering a crushing blow to the global slave trade. Between 1868 CE to 1947 CE, the Empire of Japan rose to prominence and aimed to dominate Asia and the Pacific, leading to conflict with China. The 19th century and beyond saw the rise of modern medicine. The germ theory of disease led to more effective treatments and public health measures such as better sanitation, as well as powerful new techniques such as anesthesia, moved medical science forward. This, alongside the Industrial Revolution and increased agricultural productivity, meant that the human population exploded. Around 1800 CE, there were only 1 billion people in the world, and 2 centuries later, the world's population had increased more than sevenfold to over 7 billion people. Between 1870 CE to 1914 CE, the Second Industrial Revolution took place, also known as the Technological Revolution. It saw the widespread adoption of pre-existing technological systems such as electrical power, as well as new technological systems such as telephones. Between 1914 CE and 1918 CE, World War I took place. The assassination of Austro-Hungarian heir Archduke Franz Ferdinand by a Slav nationalist set off a crisis in Europe, as entangled international alliances were invoked and the major European powers went to war. The conflict spread around the world, and this was industrialized warfare on an epic scale. By the end of the war, or soon after, the German, Russian, Austro-Hungarian, and Ottoman empires all ceased to exist, and the map of Europe was redrawn. The misery of World War I triggered the Russian Revolution of 1917 CE, which led to the creation of the world's first socialist state and the formation of the Soviet Union in 1922 CE. The humiliation of Germany at the end of World War I helped lead to the rise of Nazi Germany. Racism, especially anti-Semitism, was a central feature of the regime. As Nazi Germany made increasingly aggressive territorial demands across Europe, war was declared by the UK and France in 1939 CE, marking the start of World War II. Many other countries were drawn into the war, and Nazi Germany was finally defeated in 1945 CE. During the final stages of World War II, after Japan's attack on Pearl Harbor in the US state of Hawaii, the US detonated 2 nuclear bombs over the Japanese cities of Hiroshima and Nagasaki. These bombings remained the only use of nuclear weapons in the history of warfare so far. After World War II, the ideology of communism spread across Central Europe, and communist governments were formed in several countries. After the two world wars, anti-colonialist movements also picked up steam, and many countries gained their independence from foreign rule. Between 1947 CE and 1991 CE, the Cold War saw a state of geopolitical tension exist between the two world superpowers at the time, the Soviet Union and the US. In 1949 CE, Communist China, known as the People's Republic of China, was founded. In this post-war period, the speed of change, especially in science and technology, accelerated, and the world became more and more connected. In the 1950s, the study of DNA and genetics revolutionized biomedical science. Later in that same decade, the invention of the silicon chip heralded the computer age. From 1960 CE, the modern oral contraceptive pill started to become widely available to women, transforming lives and leading to a dramatic change in women's education and participation in the labor market. In 1969 CE, the first manned moon landing took place. 1989 CE to 1991 CE saw the collapse of communism across Europe. Despite its high ideals, in practice, communism had led to low production and mass poverty, which resulted in its rejection across the region. In 1989 CE, the World Wide Web was invented, and that, along with the internet, revolutionized communication and created new industries. In 2001 CE, the War on Terror began when Islamic fundamentalists attacked the Twin Towers in America. In retaliation, the US invaded Afghanistan, and radical religious terrorism remains a threat. In 2019 CE, the world was gripped by a global pandemic, and medical science and globalization allowed the consequences of the disease to be stemmed in an unprecedented way. Humanity continues to face a number of challenges such as climate change, the threat of nuclear war, and resource scarcity, but humanity is also experiencing a pace of technological development never before seen, which may ultimately equip mankind to rise to these challenges. This video is a broad overview of the history of everything, and it would be impossible to highlight every empire and every moment in all of human history. When writing the script for this video, a key criteria for inclusion was to consider what events affected the most people and what moved the human story forward. I've tried my best to cover as much as possible and to create a narrative explaining where we came from and how we got to where we are today. I've created a book associated with this video, and the link to the book will be in the description. As always, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video, and remember to like, comment, and subscribe.